afternoon and welcome to Short and Sweet Yoga Tuesdays. I'm Joy Scola here at Treehouse Yoga in Austin, Texas. We have a wide variety of classes that are completely donation-based for you to choose from and try out, especially if you've never been to a studio before or have tried yoga or wanted to try a new style. Please come, we welcome you all. So I realize today tensions can be high. I myself have chosen to try and stay out of everything that's going on and not really watch too much of it or even really try to talk about it a whole lot. But I realize it is on other people's minds and this is a big deal, obviously. So I want us to be able to release some of that tension and some of that anxiety and then be able to really just kind of calm our nervous system and remember that all is well. And no matter what happens, we'll still be here and it'll be okay. And we'll be alive, living our lives. So let's go ahead and come to a comfortable seated position. Just take a moment here to kind of check in and see how you're feeling. Are you affected by all of this crazy energy? Are you sensitive to that? Have you not noticed a shift in anything? How has the current political climate or cultural climate affected you internally? Are you excited to be shooken up and to welcome change? Or does it make you hesitant, fearful? Do not give a rat's butt. Really check in here and see if there is any part that you start to feel that anxiousness or that anxiety, or if you felt offended at all, why? Without any judgment, why? What about that was triggering for you? And how can you try to let go of your personal agenda and the way you want things to unfold? How can you let that go to just accept what's going to happen and that you've done the best you can, you've done everything in your power, now it's time to let it go and see what comes about? I invite you to set an intention here. I think my personal intention would be to let go whatever sort of crazy energy comes into my field, recognize that it's not necessarily my own, and just let it flow right back out as quickly as it flowed in. So I want to start us off with an om. This doesn't have to be spiritual or esoteric. It's more so, in my opinion, to massage the vocal cords, massage the nervous system, which will help to regulate how we feel and help to calm us. If you notice that when you're laying in bed at night and you start to feel really relaxed and you go, that is actually telling your vagus nerve right there that it is time to relax. So oming kind of just has that similar effect. So we're gonna take one inhale fully, exhale it fully out, and then we'll inhale to om just one time. Let's just give it a shot. You don't have to if you don't want to. Inhaling fully, exhaling it all out. Inhale nice and big, nice slow. Beautiful. Let's go ahead and come into child's pose. Down onto our mat, you can take wide knee or knees together, whatever you're needing here. Sometimes I like to really curl up into my shell if I'm just feeling like I want to really go inward. Be by myself. And as you breathe here, you can start to roll the forehead side to side. Really letting the neck go, really mindfully, nice and slow, so you don't push past your limit. And if your palms were up by your feet, you can stretch them out in front of you, palms down, and pull your mat back in towards your shoulders down towards your spine, and your tailbone down towards your toes. While simultaneously reaching your scalp long, your neck is reaching out of the shoulders. And then exhale, walking the hands to the right, stretching out with that left hand long, reaching our left hip back towards our heel. Really just surrendering in this pose. Where can you find that childlike wonderment and humility? Inhale back to center. Exhale on over to the left, reaching really long through that right hand now. If you remember a time when you were a child that you really didn't have a care as to what happened in your day. You just woke up feeling so good and excited and no pressures or stresses. Summertime maybe, school's out. Try and embody that here. Inhaling the hands back to center. One more nice big inhale. And then exhale, coming to tabletop, taking the knees under the hips. Inhale, dropping the belly, letting the shoulders round. I'm reaching the top of my scalp that's like right above the roof of my mouth up. So I'm not cranking my neck ever. And then as I exhale, I'm letting that exhale start the movement of my spine arching up. Belly pulling in. Inhale to pull the ground away. And exhale, push back down. Moving however feels good for your body. You can start a jump rope motion here. Inhaling to drop the belly, exhaling to round up, and then switching directions. Inhale, drop. Moving with mindfulness, listening to your body. One more exhale, coming back to tabletop. Slip the hands out just a little bit more in front of you and lift up, press back, down dog. Pulling the hips back towards the feet. You can have as much of a bend here as you'd like. And I'm really pressing into the pads of my fingers and my palms, so that way the center of my palm is kind of tenting up. Taking a few moments here to breathe. And pedal out your down dog. And then inhale, lift the left leg up. Keeping the hips parallel, holding. You can even put a deeper bend in that right knee. And then inhale, stack the hips, keeping your pressure even in both palms still. Pulling that heel towards your glute. And then inhale back to center. Exhale, step that left foot forward. Lower your right foot. Coming up, you can bring your hands onto your hips or reach your arms up tall. Little lunge here. So I'm really having that inner spiral lifting up to engage my hips, my core. And then exhale, I'm gonna place my hands to the mat, walk my foot just a little bit more forward, and then exhale, pull my hips back to straighten my front leg. If you need to step your knee back, your back knee back, just a little bit to keep your hips stacked over your knee, you can do so. And then I'm just giving a slight fascia tension here. So I'm just kind of pulling back, tugging back on my heel. So that way I can feel it just in the outer tissue. And then now we are going to bring that foot back to lunge. Inhale, arms up. And then as we exhale, we're going to straighten that front leg, lowering our hands. And let's do that a couple more times. Inhale, moving with your breath. Exhale, pressing those hips back. One more time. Holding here. If you want to give a nice light back bend, you can. Letting the front of the hips drop down. And then exhale, folding over that front leg. And then inhale, step your hands forward, pull that foot back. Exhale, chaturanga. You can do knees, chest, chin. Pull through up dog or cobra. Pressing into the tops of the feet. Exhale. Pulling back to down dog. Shake it out. Do what you need to do here. And then inhale, reach the right foot up and hold. Keeping the hips parallel, dropping your right hip down, pulling your left hip up, right heel up towards the ceiling. You can even add a nice bend in that left knee now. Pulling your weight back into your hips. And then inhale, stack the right hip over the left, pulling your right heel into your left glute. Keeping both hands evenly pressing into your mat. So I'm not opening up here. My chest is rotating back down towards the earth. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, sweep that right leg forward. And you can drop the back knee. Inhale, up to a low lunge. And really pressing in to that front knee. Trying to keep the hips level, inward spiral up. Whoop, it's like a zipper. Whoop. If you need to put a blanket or fold your mat over to protect your knee, that's totally okay. Inhale the arms up. Exhale, reach the hands down. You can step your foot out just a little bit further if you need to. Pulling your hips back. Straighten your front leg. Going easy on my body, staying soft. And then now we'll go for a little movement. We'll reach forward, inhale the arms up, exhale, straighten the front leg, the hands down, inhale, arms up, and exhale, straighten the front leg, a couple more times. And on your next.
next lunge, hold. You can do a slight back bend here if that feels good for you. Making sure you can breathe here. And then exhale, straighten that front leg. And then placing your hands back down, coming to the lunge, step that foot back. You can lower your knees, chest and chin, slide the hips back, lift the hips slightly as you roll your shoulders back and down, pulling your hands back towards your hips. Exhale, see if you can do a reverse push-up and pull back. If not, no worries. I didn't start out being able to do that. Next, we're gonna bend our knees deeply, look at the top of our mat, step, hop, or float to the front. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, deep bend in the knees as you have a nice supported spine. Inhale, up, open. And I'm hitting a dream catcher, bringing the hands back to heart center. I really placed my mat in a perfect spot here. I'm gonna get attacked. All right. So now we're gonna build some more fire. We're gonna inhale, reach the arms up tall, and then exhale, step your left foot back, warrior two, bend in that left knee, really pressing back and down through that right heel, and then pulling up through the center to reach out, extend, and then pulling these hips open, inflating both of my ribs, both my rib cage, building fire. Inhale, keep that bend in your front knee and reverse your warrior. And then exhale, warrior two. Inhale, side angle. Inhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse warrior. Inhale, warrior two. Straighten that front leg. Exhale, triangle. Inhale, strong legs back up. Turn the toes out towards the side of your mat. Slight bend in your knees. As you exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway rise. And then exhale, I'm gonna turn my toes out just a little bit and come down into a squat. That's okay for you. You can always scoot your heels in somewhat. And then if you want to, actually you don't even have to be that low. Well, inhale, reach up. Exhale, sink down. So really making sure that you use the bottom and the top of your glute. Inhale up. Exhale down. Stay really lifted. Inhale up. Exhale down. Hold here. Exhale, pressing over to the left. Inhale back to center. Exhale, pressing over to the right. Inhale back to center. Double time. One more time each side. And slowly turn those toes forward. Exhale, forward fold. You can walk your hands, turn your fingers away from you and walk your hands back towards your mat. Pulling the shoulders out, back and down. If you want to take an inversion here, you can. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, deep bend in the knees to stand up. Turn your left toes out. Right toes come in just a little bit. Warrior two. Hold and breathe. Rooting down as I exhale. I'm sending my breath down into the container of the earth. As I inhale, pulling that energy back up and extending out. Staying connected through my whole body. I'm engaged even though I'm stretching. Inhale, deep bend in that knee. Reaching back to reverse warrior. Exhale, left knee, left elbow to left knee, side angle. Inhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse warrior. Inhale, warrior two. Exhale, straighten that front leg. Inhale, triangle. How can I inflate my right lung here, pulling it back in towards my imaginary wall to open? Sending that hip down. Inhale, back up. Exhale, turn the toes forward. Forward fold. Shake out the head here, whatever you're needing. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, deep bend in the knees, using the strength of your legs to support your back up. Exhale, step to the front of your mat. And pause here. How does this heat feel in your body? Do you feel more jacked up? Do you feel more grounded? Do you feel the same or nothing at all? Your experience is your experience. Slight bend in the knees here so I can really press and root down through my feet, which lifts the arches, lifting the chest. Inhale, reach the arms up, optional back bend. Exhale, swan dive forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold, step or float your feet back. Knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga, cobra, up dog. Pressing back, downward dog. Inhale, step up, or float. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, rise. There's always a level for everybody. There's always a modification for everyone. Find what feels good for you. Inhale, reach the arms up tall. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Step top or float to the back. Chaturanga or knees, chest, chin. Lifting cobra, up dog. Exhale, use your low belly to lift and pull back if you can. Shake it out, shake it out. I love like using song choruses as like my mantras, like let it go, let it go. That's like one of my favorites too. But find what inspires you. Inspires you to release and just be. Now inhale the left leg up. Exhale, step it to the outside of your left hand. So it's right along the edge of your mat. And you can just hang out here for a little lizard action. So I'm letting my right knee drop just a little bit, but I'm staying active through that heel. And I still have that inward spiral happening in the hips here. Otherwise I'd be kind of collapsed like this. Engaged. And then we can exhale, slowly lower that knee. Inhale,
extend that back heel to lift. Exhale, lower that knee, just so it hovers a little bit off the ground. Exhale, extend the heel. With your own breath, a few more rounds. One last time. And then fully lower that knee. You can untuck the toes if that feels good for your knee. And hugging your left knee into your left shoulder, you can try to reach your elbows down or hands to a block or bolster, blanket, couch cushion, you name it. Just breathe here. How can you stay soft in your face? And how can you stay soft in your life and in your mindset? Sometimes I have a tendency to harden and be like, no, no. But I need to let go and trust that it all happens for a reason. It's all necessary. Inhale, you can start to lift the chest back up if you lower down. And then we're going to step the right hand out to the edge of our mat. Inhale, sweep the left arm up and open the chest out. So we're really twisting at the hips, which will help our spine to open. So inhale, inflate that left rib cage, expressing the heart up and open. And then exhale, the hand back down. Sweep that left foot back. You can knees, chest, chin here. Cobra or up dog. Exhale, lifting back to down dog. Inhale, lift your right leg up. Exhale, step it forward just to the outside of your right hand along the right edge of your mat. And then hovering with your left knee, staying really engaged here. How can you stay engaged but soft, but supple? How can you release this tension down into the container of the earth? How can you let the earth help support you and hold some of what's too much to carry? Now inhale, we're gonna just lightly lower that knee all the way a few inches off the mat. Exhale, extend that right heel. Inhale, dropping the knee. Inhale, extend. If you have any twinges or anything like that, feel free to skip this. You can just lower that knee down and maybe work on stretching your foot and then tucking your foot. Stretching your foot, tucking your foot. I was feeling a twinge, so I think I'm gonna stick with this. I gotta listen, you know? There are some things I wanna teach you, but if it doesn't feel good for me, what's the point? All right, and then you can lift back up if that feels good or stay down, but then we're really just gonna stretch into this lizard here, making sure you're comfortable, putting a pad under your knee if you need to, a blanket, folding up your mat. And then exhale, you can start to drop your elbows down if they reach, or you can drop them to a block, bolster, pillow. Make sure you're pulling that right knee into your right shoulder still. Or if it does feel good, you can drop that knee open, coming onto the edge of your foot. But I feel like with everything that's going on, let's try and stay a little more contained. If we get too deep in the hips, that really starts to get a little emotional at times. I think it's about regulating today.
Chaturanga. Lowering your belly. Inhale, lifting up to Cobra or Up Dog. Exhale, down dog. Take what you need. And then exhale, let's come forward onto our knees into tabletop. Inhale, put your left hand towards the middle of your mat, reaching your right arm up tall while your hips stay parallel to the floor. And then exhale, slide that arm through, and then go ahead and place your ear, if it's comfortable, down to the mat. So I'm stretching my ear away from my shoulder as I lower my head down. And then now I'm pulling my hip back. And then I'm kind of like really pulling more with the right hip so I can get some tension along this outer edge of my right shoulder. You can even place your palm, your left palm on top of your right palm. Press into that to help open, but go slow, listen. Listen first. Will it feel okay tomorrow if you go this deep, do you think? Or do you think you can do it dialing it back like 10 to 30%? What's your body want? And then go ahead and place that left hand back down, really pressing it. Reach the right arm back up. Exhale the right arm down. Inhale, left arm reaches up tall, hips stay square. Exhale, thread that left hand through and stretch the neck long away from the shoulder to plant that ear, and then pulling back through with that left hip. I'm going to take my right palm on top of my left because this feels good for me, and press to pull open into this area. You can even take your hand behind your back for a bind, or just keep it planted on the ground. Right hand comes back to support you as you lift that left arm. And exhale, the hands back down. Taking the knees about as wide as your mat or as comfortable as you can get. Starting to lower your hands out and away from you as you bring your chest down. In these times, we can start to quarrel with family and friends, and people are drawing lines in the sand, or tensions are high. How can we bow to one another? We're allowed to have our own opinions. We're allowed to vote for different people. We're allowed to have different ideals, different style. And even if it's not what we like, big deal. That's why we live where we live. We're not prosecuted for what we believe. I love that about this world, about our country. We can say what we want. Not everybody has that luxury. And then if you can, start to slide all the way up onto your belly, bringing your hands by your side. You can bring your chin down or dropping to one ear or the other. Just breathing with the earth for a moment. As you inhale, can you feel the earth inhaling with you? And then as you exhale, can you feel the earth exhaling with you? Inhaling to fill your belly, feel it along your mat. Breathe into that space and then melt into it. Breathe in to create space. Exhale to melt deeper. Inhale, the chin to center. If it's not, taking your hands by your shoulders, but out a few inches from your mat on either side,
putting a tent in your hands here. So I'm up on the fingertip pads. Inhale, I'm gonna roll my shoulders back and down. My neck is long. Exhale, I'm gonna dip my left elbow as I look over to my right. I can drop my head down. Inhale, back up to center. Exhale, dropping the right shoulder down as I look to the left. Inhale, up, exhaling to rotate, moving with your own breath. Staying active in the legs. Allowing the tailbone to lift slightly as you lift your shoulders to support a breathe easy back bend. And then inhale up to center. Exhale, bring the palms back underneath your shoulders, and exhale, pull back to a child's pose. If you can, if it feels right, bring your knees together or have them wide, but then place your palms up by your feet, lowering your forehead. We'll come back to this place for a moment. Have you felt any areas softening? Have you discovered any new points of tension? How can you work with your body to help it feel better? Coming back to center, we'll bring the palms back underneath the shoulders. To inhale, sit up nice and slow. You can stay seated on your knees here. Just taking a moment for the transition. Sometimes I feel a little flush of blood as it comes back down through my body. And then you can sit to one hip or the other, swing the hips out. We're gonna lay back. Ooh, got some pops going. And you can just bring your feet a little bit wider than hips distance apart, letting the knees drop in. Let that natural curve of your spine happen here. So you've got some space. See that? Mm-hmm. Let that natural arc in your neck happen as well. So now we're gonna lift the shins up to tabletop, and then we're gonna lift our forearms up to tabletop as well. I'm going to stack my left knee over my right, and if this is as far as you can go, you can just work on pressing your left foot, the left of your left foot, razor edge, into your right side shin here. Or you can go for a full eagle bind. Now, since my right leg is underneath, my right arm will be on top. It's always the opposite of each other. Taking a moment here, I'm going to inhale, stretch long, and then exhale, squeeze in. I'm going to try and bring my elbow to my knee. Inhale, stretch long. Inhaling to wring out anything we don't need, and exhale. Expel it. Last time, inhale. And unwind, bringing your feet back down to the ground, knees together. Do you still feel a sense of unwinding in your body? I feel like I'm like out this way. So now let's see if we can reverse that to make it even. So we're gonna lift the shins, lift the forearms. Stack the right knee over the left, and again, I can just press my outer foot into my outer shin, or I can go for a full wrap here. And then since my left is on the bottom, my left will be on the top. Inhale, pull those shoulders wide. You have a wide shoulder girdle here. Extend the arms, extend the legs. Exhale to pull in. Don't use your neck to lift up. Use your belly. Use your breath. And one more time. And inhale, slowly unwind, bringing the feet back down, letting the knees drop in. And inhale, bring the knees into the chest. Thank you, knees. Thank you, body, for carrying me through this crazy life, for doing all the things I demand of you. And then inhale, stretching out and open, then bringing the hands back down by the sides. Sockets. Unfurl your eyebrows. Release your jaw. Release your ears. Let go of your tongue. Go of your throat. Go of your chest. Let your shoulders get heavy and melt into the earth. Feel your forearms and your palm and your fingers releasing. Your belly and your back, let go. The top of the pelvis, your psoas releases. You can feel a little shudder kind of come through your body. Letting the legs become as heavy as tree trunks. Reaching as deep as roots down into the floor. So it almost feels like your feet are disappearing into the earth and you're sinking like quicksand. Always be open to new ideas, for our resistance to change is what heightens our suffering, emphasizes it, makes it seem greater than it needs to be. You'll survive. You'll still be friends with your friends, family with your family. You'll still feel the love and admiration for all those important to you and close to you in your life. Everything will carry on. It always will. Long as you need to, but if you want, start to deepen your breath. Can you send your breath to your toes? What would that feel like? Can you send your breath to your fingertips? Can you feel it travel from your lungs, through your shoulders, down your arms, and into your palm, and then out through your fingers? Start to wiggle, gently rolling wrists and ankles. knees and elbows. Overhead, arms, body stretch. And then exhale, rolling to one side, come into a fetal position. Be supported with your top hand. Just accepting here. Whatever it is you want to accept, whatever it is you want to take in. And feel free to leave behind in this moment, shed it, let it go. Drop it at your side as if it were a dirty towel or shirt. Can you leave right here? As you exhale, send it out, sitting up tall, coming to a comfortable position. Inhale, the palms together. May we remember that we are all humans. First and foremost, a spirit with a body. Not the other way around. May we remember that each has had to walk their own paths. Each has had to deal with their own obstacles. Each person has had to participate in their own sufferings. We may not understand the reasons of why people may act the way they do or treat others or think or feel. We don't have to. All we can do is look within and work on ourselves. Show ourselves humility and compassion and extend that outward to all living things. Breathe, and you'll be present. Namaste.